What's poppin', y'all? It's your girl Amber, and you are watching Y School Music TV. Today, we're here and we're gonna be interviewing DJ Dutchy.
What's good, yo? It's DJ Dutchy. Black Audio, how you guys doing today? Big shout out to my boy Wise Fool. You know how we do.
All right, Dutchy, so where are you from?
I'm originally from Flatbush.
And how long have you been DJing?
16 years now.
So how old are you now?
I'm 22.
22 years old, yeah. And already 16 years of DJing.
Yeah.
How many mixtapes do you have out right now?
Four.
What are they
currently
called?
Working on the fifth one. I have the best reggae. That's the R&B. I have a slow jam, and I also have a ladies' night and a special night, Red Light District.
Ah, very nice. And what kind of clubs? Like, how many clubs have you played? What kind?
Well, a couple ones I could name out is Club Shelter. That's in Manhattan. I did a Voodoo Lounge in Manhattan. Also did some clubs in Brooklyn. A club called Limbies. I did that in Brooklyn, New York. And also, I did a lot of basement parties and house parties.
It's been a couple years?
Yeah, I did one here actually. That was a while back though. That was about probably 4 or 5 years ago. That's actually when I was in high school. I did that for my 18th birthday. It was packed out too.
Alright, so where did you come up with the name DJ Dutch?
Well, DJ Dutch was given to me from Brooklyn when I was at least 13, 14 years old, back in the streets, actually. I used to roll Dutchess back then. I used to roll it real tight, so I got the name DJ Dutchy. Also, Dutchy in Jamaican is kind of like the pot where they make like chicken in, and I'm always in that pot of chicken, so they're like, oh, so you're Dutch, huh? I'm gonna start calling you Dutch. So, you know, I got the name DJ Dutchy. I was a DJ. My first name was gonna be DJ J, but it just didn't rock with it, so I just came up with the name DJ Dutch. Well, the street called me DJ Dutch.
Alright.
I just ran with it.
And who are some of your biggest influences to being a DJ?
I got a lot. Well, cousin for starters, because he actually got me in the game from a young age, actually. Also, DJ Jam Master J is a real good influence on me, too. We got my other DJ Dougie Fresh. Couple other people, but they're like family members, not anyone out in the industry really, because I was always a humble guy when it came to that.
All right, so who do you think right now, like in the music scene, who do you think is the real deal? Who do you think really fit in the group?
D-Roy X. He's nice. That dude's the truth. Also Jay-Z, always Brooklyn, always on top. I mean, Lil Wayne got some stuff, but I'm not really a big Lil Wayne fan.
Yeah.
He's alright. Jada Kid, Stab, those are the real truth. They're the real heavy hitters for me, personally.
Alright, and what's the biggest difference between using vinyl, MP3, Serato, and CD?
Well, first of all, vinyl, that's like the number one thing. It's a different feeling from any other equipment, from Serato, MP3. Vinyl is kind of like a manual thing, you know, like how you have stick and you have automatic. Well, when you use vinyl, you're using a needle, you have to be very careful with it. If you do it too hard, you might scratch the record, the needle might fly off. With a CD now, you can just put the CD in and press play and do whatever you got, because it got all kind of technology underneath it.
Yeah.
Serato, it's kind of like hook it up to the laptop and you're just working with the laptop, you're just pressing buttons, like you're cueing it in. So, personally, I think like vinyl is where it's at. Get more bass, you get more feeling to it. But for now, I'm using CDs because it's easier to carry around in the club. We don't want to be in a club with records trying to go through people. It's kind of hard.
You mentioned D-Roy before as being a heavy hitter. What do you mean by that?
Well, for starters, D-Roy is basically like one of my first artists from that. When we was actually in this basement, we started off. D-Roy's a rap artist. He's on XDMG. He's a big heavy hitter. Towards me, I think he's like one of the biggest upcoming artists as far as lyrics, as far as doing beats, as far as doing everything. you know, I stand fully 100% behind D-Roy, you know, because it was basically me and D-Roy first started as DJ Dutchie, and then it was D-Roy. And yeah, so he's a heavy hitter towards me.
So you guys are close?
Yeah, we're real close. Actually, so close that he just might be behind you.
D-Roy! Look who showed up. Yeah. Aren't we lucky?
Good.
Well, D-Roy, how you doing?
I'm all right.
All right, why don't you tell us about some of the things that you're doing and how you're working with DJ Dutchie?
Oh, man, you know, DJ Dutchie, man, you know, we go back. We go way back. You know what I'm saying? When I was, like, 16, we met up. I was doing the beatbox thing, you know, a little something like charge out for the rest of that, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, I did the beatbox thing, and he heard about me. You know, they told us we needed to do something together.
Ooh.
He had to, like, reggae flow. You know, I'm from Brooklyn as well. Canarsie, so, you know, brought up. But I live in Jersey, you know, so we do that Jersey wave too. You know, because I'm kind of stuck to move. So, you know, he told us, you know, we need to hook up and do some things. And ever since then, it's been history. You know, what I'm doing right now, just came off tour with Pitt. We just went around the country. Revolution Tour. What's up, Pitt? 305. David Rush, what's up, man? I'm here. You already know XPMG. It's in the moon. You know, so we here. It's your boy, Rockstar DR. They know what it is.
How long you been rapping?
How long I've been rapping? About 5-6 years. I do beats, I beatbox, break dance. What you mean? That's what I do. I do a
How
lot.
How old are you?
I'm only 23.
22. And you guys are working together right now?
Yes, we are working together. We're going to actually be doing some clubs, some clubs in Jersey, New York. So, you know. I'm gonna get it really rocking, you know, 210, you know, 2000. Gonna really get it rocking out here. You know, it's about time.
Sounds good.
It's about time Jersey take it over, you know. Jersey had that, you know, New York had their run. Time for Jersey do something out here.
DJ Dutchie promised us a little bit of DJing before we went.
Hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling.